Good morning, children. Today we are going to learn semester 2, chapter 13, time. Time is measured in hours, minutes and seconds. We use a clock or a watch to know the time. A clock has two hands. Longer hand shows the minutes and shorter hand shows the hours. If the short hand is between 3 and 4, it is past 3 o'clock. If it is between 7 and 8, it is past 7 o'clock. So, long hand on 1, then the time in minutes is 5. Long hand on 2, then time in minutes is 10. Likewise, if it is on 3, then 15, 4, 20, 5, 25, 6, 30, 7, 35, 8, 40, 9, 45, 10, 50, 11, 55. It is nothing but multiplication table 5. 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. So, when the long hand is on 12, it is 60 minutes. It becomes 1 hour. So, we write 00 minutes. Hours and minutes are written separated by a colon. 2 o'clock and 15 minutes is written as 2 colon 15. Now let us do it. Read the time on the clocks and write it in the box. See here, in A bit, short hand is showing at 12 and long hand is showing at minutes. So 5 threes are 15 here. So short hand is showing at 12 means hours hand, right? So the time is 12 hours 15 minutes. Likewise, you write rest of the sums on your own. Now conversion of time. 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. To change minutes to hours, divide by 60. 480 minutes to hours. 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. 1 minute equal to 1 by 60 hours. So, 480 divided by 60 is equal to 8 hours. Check the working column over here. See, 480 if we divide by 60, that is 8 hours. 480 minus 480 is 0 minutes. And hours here, quotient is 8. So, 8 hours is the answer. Likewise, you see the second example. 275 minutes to hours. See here, 270 divided by 60, that is equal to 4 hours 35 minutes. 64s are 240. So, we have to subtract 240 from 275. So, answer is here, 35 minutes is the remainder and the quotient is 4 hours. So, 275 minutes is equal to 4 hours 35 minutes. Now, one more example you see. 1 hour equal to 60 minutes. To change hours to minutes, multiply by 60. Example here, see. 2 hours is equal to 2 into 60 minutes. That is equal to 120 minutes. As I said, you 1 hour equal to 60 minutes. So, 2 hours is equal to 2 into 60 minutes. How much it is? 120 minutes. Likewise, see here 3 hours 50 minutes. 3 into 60 minutes plus 50 minutes. So it is 180 minutes plus 50 minutes is equal to 230 minutes. Now let us do it. See here, change the hours to minutes. That means what we have to do? Do multiplication by 60 minutes. 3 hours. They have given the question. So 3 into 60 minutes. That is equal to how much? 180 minutes. Likewise, rest of the sums, you do it on your own. Now, change the minutes to hours. What we have to do here? Do division by 60. So, here, a bit, 420 minutes they have given. So, 420 divided by 60, then our answer is 7 hours. Likewise, rest of the sums, you do it on your own. Now read, understand and solve. If I traveled for 2 hours 40 minutes, how many minutes did I travel? That means here what we are doing, we are multiplying first. 2 into 60. 2 hours, right? 2 into 60 is equal to 120 minutes plus 40 minutes we are adding here. So answer is 160 minutes altogether I have traveled. Now see here one more question. How many hours are there in 310 minutes? So if we divide 310 by 60, then our answer will come as 5 hours and 10 minutes. But what they asked here, how many hours are there in 310 minutes? So I have written the answer as 5 hours. Okay, now we shall see one more. Here, there are 24 hours in a day. So the shorthand goes round the clock 2 times. One round is 12 hours. When the long hand goes one round of the clock, it is 60 minutes or 1 hour. So the long hand moves round the clock 24 times in a day. Now you see here, the first 12 hours begin after 12 o'clock midnight and continue up to 12 o'clock noon. We use AM for this period. AM means anti-meridian. Now you see the second part. The second 12 hours begin after 12 o'clock noon or midday up to, and it continues up to 12 o'clock midnight. So we use this time as PM. That is, for this period we use PM. PM means post meridian. Now table to remember. One day is equal to 24 hours. 1 hour equal to 60 minutes. 1 minute equal to 60 seconds. 1 week equal to 7 days. 1 month is equal to 30 will be there in some months and 31 days will be there in the other months, except February, 28 days will have. Okay, and 1 year is equal to 365 days or 12 months or 52 weeks. We can say for 1 year. Now conversion of days to hours. 1 day is equal to 24 hours. So 2 days is equal to 2 into 24 is equal to how much? 48 hours. 5 days is equal to 5 into 24 is equal to 120 hours. Now let us do it. Change from days to hours. 3 days into 24 hours is equal to how much? If we multiply, then it is 72 hours. Likewise, the rest of the sums, you do it on your own. Now fill in the blanks. 1 hour equal to how many minutes? 60 minutes. 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. And 1 week, we say it as, how many days are there for 1 week? 7 days. 1 year is equal to 365 days. 192 hours is equal to how many days? Then what we do here? We do the division. 192 divided by 24 hours is equal to 8 days. Now, 2 years, if 1 year, if we have 52 weeks, then 2 years, that means 52 into 2 is equal to 104 weeks will be there for 2 years. Now, addition and subtraction. Add 3 hours 15 minutes and 6 hours 20 minutes. First, what we have to do? We have to add the minutes column and then add the hours column. Now, if we do the addition, see here 5 plus 0 is 5, 2 plus 1 is 3, 35 minutes. Now, move to the hours. 3 plus 6 is 9. So, altogether the answer is 9 hours, 35 minutes. Now see one more example. 5 hours 35 minutes and 3 hours 40 minutes. See here. Now we arranged in hours and minutes. First, what we have to do here? See, 35 plus 40 is 75 minutes. That means 1 hour 15 minutes it is. See if we add the working column, you see here. 35 plus 40 is 75 minutes. That means 1 hour 15 minutes. Right. So, what we have to do here? We have to write 15 in minutes column and carry over 1 hour to the hours column. So, here 1 plus 5 is 6. 6 plus 3 is 9. So, our answer is 9 hours 15 minutes. Likewise, you see one more example. Add 15 hours 45 minutes and 22 hours 50 minutes. Now first what we have to do, we have to add the minutes. So if we add the minutes, 45 plus 50, answer is 95 minutes. So here how many hours are there? 1 hour 35 minutes in this, right? So write 35 minutes in minutes column and carry over 1 to the hours column. Here, place value house, 1's place is there, 10's place is also there. So, this carry over 1, we have to put in 1's place and add. Now, 1 plus 5 is 6 and 6 plus 2 is 8. Right. So write 8 in 1's column and move to the 10's column. That is 10's place value. So 1 plus 2 is 3. So write 3 in 10's column. So our answer is 38 hours 35 minutes. Likewise, do the subtraction. 15 hours 45 minutes minus 7 hours 30 minutes. Here's step 1. First, what we have to do, we have to subtract the minutes. So, 5 minus 0 is 5. 4 minus 3 is 1. Now, then subtract the hours. So, 5 minus 7, can we subtract? No. So, we have to borrow from 10's place. So, this 1 goes to 1's column and this 5 will become as 15. So, 15 minus 7 is 8. So, 8 hours, 15 minutes is the answer. Now, 43 hours, 30 minutes minus 10 hours, 45 minutes. 43 hours, 30 minutes minus 10 hours, 45 minutes. So, first what we have to do? We have to subtract the minutes. So, 30 is less than 45. So, we have to borrow 1 hour from 43 hours. So, 1 hour is equal to how much? 60 minutes. So, in step 3, 30 plus 60 we have to add. Then, this becomes as 90 minutes. Okay. Now, in fourth step, we have to subtract from 90. 90 minus 45 is equal to 45 minutes. So, write 45 minutes in minutes column and then move to the hours column. Now, subtract the hours. Here, 2 remains, right? 1 hour we have borrowed, we have given to the minutes. That means, here minutes have been borrowed, 1 hour. So, 2 remains here. So, 42 minus 10 is equal to, here how much? That means, 2 minus 0 is 2, 4 minus 1 is 3. So, 42 minus 10 is 32 hours 45 minutes. If minutes are 60 or more than 60, we should move the number to hours. Now, let us do it. Do the addition. A bit. 75 hours 35 minutes plus 10 hours 25 minutes. So, first we shall add. 35 plus 25 is 60 minutes. So, we can't write 60 minutes directly. Just now I told you, no, if minutes are 60 or more than 60, we should move the number to hours column. So put the zeros in minutes column and move the hour to 1 hour to the hours column. So here 1 plus 5 is 6. So write 6 down. 7 plus 1 is 8 in tens column. So the answer is 86 hours. Likewise, you do the B, C and D bits. Now move to the subtraction. Hours, minutes. 83 hours 45 minutes minus 45 hours 30 minutes. So how you subtract? 5 minus 0 is 5. 4 minus 3 is 1. Again in hours column, tens place is there. Tens and ones and tens are there, right? So here can we subtract 3 minus 5? No. So we have to borrow from tens place to the ones place. So this 3 becomes 13, right? So 13 minus 5 is 8 and here 7 will be there. So 7 minus 4 is 3. The total time is now here. Answer is 38 hours 15 minutes. So rest of the sums you do it on your own. Now read, think and solve. Sachin practiced for 3 hours 45 minutes on Monday and 2 hours 15 minutes on Tuesday. How much time did he practice altogether? Solution. Sachin practiced on Monday. Write in hours and minutes column 3 hours 45 minutes. And on Tuesday 2 hours 15 minutes. So if we do addition for both 3 hours 45 plus 2 hours 15 minutes, answer is 6 hours. So Sachin practiced for 6 hours. Now one more question is, on a day I travelled for 15 hours 45 minutes. Out of this I travelled 12 hours 50 minutes by car and the rest by flight. How much time did I travel by flight? Now solution you see. On a day, I travelled is 15 hours 45 minutes. Now travelled by car is minus, we have to do. How many hours and minutes? 12 hours 50 minutes. Right. So here 45 minutes plus 60. We have to add, then this becomes as 105. So 45 plus 60 is equal to 105. So minus 50 now only we can subtract. Why? Because the upper value, this 45, is less than 50. See here, 5 minus 0, we will write 5. Can we subtract 4 minus 5? No, we can't. So what we have done here, we have borrowed 1 hour from hours column to minutes column 4. So 45 plus 60, this becomes as 105. So 105 minus 50 is equal to 55. Okay, now in minutes we will write 55 and here in hours 4 minus 2 is 2. 1 minus 1 is 0. So I travelled by flight is 2 hours 55 minutes. Now check here the calendar of 2018. See? Okay, now writing the dates. A date can be written in many ways. See here how they have written 11th August 2018 in so many ways. See, now let us do it. Fill in the blanks. When is your birthday? You write your birthday date, month and year. On what day does it fall this year? Okay, on which day it come in this year? Okay, now B bit. If Rajiv is 8 years old on 25th March 2018, when will he be 10 years old? See here. add 2 years, right? Then it becomes 25th March. By 2020, he will reach to 10 years, right? Now CBID, in which year were you promoted from class 2 to class 3, that you do it on your own, you write it. Okay, which year did you start going to school? You write this also. Now, when was Gandhiji assassinated? Assassinated means shooted. When? See the right date, month and year. 30th January 1948. Now, observe the given calendar and answer the questions. How many Sundays are there in the month of May? Check here how many Sundays are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, write the answer 4 here. How many months have 5 Saturdays? Now, check here. How many months are there? 5 Saturdays. Yeah, I got it. See, in the month of March, June, September and December. So, total how many months? 4 months. Have 5 Saturdays. On which day does Children's Day fall? Check in the calendar. November 2018. 14th. Children's Day fall on November 2018. The date 14 is on Wednesday. So write Wednesday here. On which day does the year 2018 begin? When the 1st January of 2018 came? On Monday. Right? See here. On Monday. So write Monday. Now, circle these dates on the calendar of 2018 and state the day on which they fall. So, you write the dates accordingly how they have given and you check the calendar and write on your own. Thank you, children. Take care. Stay safe.